Hello, my name is Clara, and I'm going to be showing you guys how I use Chameleon Fineliners. You can find my art at Grain Vein. I usually stay within black work, using black ink on white paper, but these fineliners have been a pretty fun way to add color into my drawings. So, I outlined a drawing that I sketched out this morning, and here it is. I did it with the black and the olive. That's black 4 and olive 3. And I think the first thing that I'm going to color in is the flowers, and we're going to make them blue. And I've picked out these two colors for the petals. So the cap can actually stay off these pens for a really long time, and they're dry safe though, so they won't dry out for a day or two. I'm gonna add this darker blue cap to this lighter turquoise and keep it on for about 1 second. And you want to keep it upright. So, let's try this out. Just a quick one. Okay. And I'm gonna make the center one a little bit lighter since it's the center, so I'm gonna keep this off. Or keep this on for a little bit shorter than for the other two. So just a quick one. Excuse me. And I've picked out these two colors for these parts, the inners of the petals, I guess. Missed a dark part. I think I'll go in after and do some more dark shading with some blue and black, but we'll finish these white parts first. So I put the light blue one on the light gray one. Okay. Let's use these two. It's the black and a really dark blue. So black 4, blue 8. Just a quick one. Black onto the blue. And put that dark blue onto this aqua that we were using earlier. Alright, so finish coloring the flowers. On to the leaves. And we're going to be using the blue 8 and the green 1. One more. All right, and next part I'm going to do is the fox, and Chameleon has a bunch of great colors, so let's see, what have we got here? So, mainly... First, anyway, I'll be using these four colors. So, start with a little bit of brown on the orange. So, brown cap, orange pen. What I find about these fineliners is that they're not just about changing from one color to another, it's blending the colors in that you get a bunch of the colors that are in between these two colors that you're using that are super sweet and make your piece look more unique and less like it's just done using like three colors. You just get so many colors in between. It's just so effective for doing colorful fur. Alright. Let's do something a little bit lighter. So I'm going to be using this orange with the nude 4. So I'm doing orange cap on the nude. Just to get some lighter highlights in. Just gonna go in with actual orange as well. And maybe some brown 3 on this orange. So many browns. Warm tones in this pack. Can't really go wrong with a fox. A little bit of this orangey nude down here. And all throughout this section. And use the brown on this nude. even get a bit of red 3 onto the nude. Get some red highlights in the fur. More. I actually really like how the red comes out on this nude. Use this brown 5, which is a little bit more grayish and less red. And I'm going to do it on this nude again. So the face looks pretty well filled in. Let's add a little bit more brown to this. A bit of shading on this side. Yes. Just all along the ears to fill that in a little bit. And we've got some fur. Now for the dark. Dark part of the ears. I think we can try just using this dark brown for now. This is the brown 5. Let's see how that turns out. We'll grab the black because we'll need something darker. Maybe we'll put the black cap on the brown. And back to orange 3, put the dark brown round 5 cap on just to blend this section. The same on the other side. I'll put brown 3 on the orange. And a little bit more color over here. And here's what we've got for fur. I think I'll add some of really pretty light color. I'll try this nude 0. And give it a little bit of an orange tint. So orange 3 on nude 0. And just add it to this white part of its face. I'm going to add a little bit of this gray 4. All right, I think we'll do the eyes now. And back to my favorite, orange 3. Super good for foxes. And at that brown 3 just very quickly. And we'll grab that black. Fill in the pupil a little bit. I think I'll use the dark brown, the brown 5, to create a little bit of depth here, a little bit more definition. I think I'll add a bit of black to the brown actually. So just a quick little bit. Just to get something a little bit darker. But not totally black. Cool. And when that part. So, we've got some eyes. I think we'll do the nose next. The nose is mostly just black. So, just go at it with the black for a sec. Not fully coloring in. But, and then I think I'll do the rest with the dark brown. And I think I'll add this brown 5 onto the nude just to blend it up a little bit up here. Just blending. Going back with the dark brown. And then the black to fill in the nostrils. And here we go. Got a nose. I think I'll do the neck next. I think do orange 3 and brown 3. Here's for the side over here. And then let's grab this nude 0 from before that we used for the white part. And add some brown 3 to it. Just a quick one. So sometimes I just take a piece of paper if it's not changing fast enough. Get it back to its base color. It's definitely needs some gray in there, so I'm using that gray 4 from before. Just to add some cooler tones. And I think I'll actually add some brown 5 to this gray for the bit of shading underneath the chin. And I'm going to add a little bit more orange 3 into the neck, just over here. Still had some brown 3 in it. So it's a little bit darker. Just filling in some of this white with a bit more of this orange. And so the fur is done. Let's do the hat next. And we'll do black on the brown 5. I'm gonna grab that black just to darken this part up a little bit. And then we'll add about 10 color in the big part. Thank you. more black on there. And I think I'll just do a little bit more filling in with the black fineliner itself. All right, and we've got the majority of the hat done onto that band. I'm gonna use this nude 4. Just add some, a little bit of color. And just a little bit of this dark brown 5 for a bit of shading. And we've got the hat. A little bit more. Cool. All right, shirt time. Just gonna use this nude. To add a little bit to the white. And then that gray as well. Just a little bit. And I think we'll do a brown jacket to match the brown hat. So that's going back to brown 5 and black. Thank you. And we'll start with the dark down here. Paper's getting a little wet from coloring. All right. Got a dark suit jacket. add some gray to the shirt. And I think we'll do a purple tie. I'm gonna do purple 4 and red 4. Let's do the purple on the red. I think I'll add some of this. I'll add some of this brown, actually. Brown 3. And lastly, a little bit of brown 5. Just for shading. Okay. And a little bit of nude 4, just for the lapel area. And we've only got the cane left. To make the cane gold to stick out from the suit jacket a little bit. Do a mix of orange 3, nude 3, and brown 4. So, doing the orange on nude 3 first. Yeah, it's a pretty nice goldy color. Some brown 3 to orange 3. Swerve it. And we'll make the top silver. Let's do a mix of gray and nude. There's a gray cap. NG4 on nude 0. Lastly, just a touch of brown 5 for a bit of shading. And there we go.